My name is Arjan, I'm the founder and creator of the Greenhouse Seed Company and the Greenhouse Coffee Shops. And next to me is Arjan's haze number 3. We are only in the second week. First week this plant went to 80 centimeters and the second week this plant went to 31 centimeters. What you can see here is the shortest internodes in the world on a haze plant. And I think we finally accomplished after 20 years of breeding to make a really short haze plant. Here we use the Laos. It's the Laos male and the female stuff comes from other countries. I'm very proud to talk about this plant because I think it's going to be definitely a Cannabis Cup winner in the future. We grow in an 85 liter container. In the day, we keep a temperature on 25, in the night on 19. The humidity around this area, we also keep on 50%. The pH we give is 5.5. The third week, so the last week of growing, it only grew 15 centimeters and now it's 46. And as you remember, all the other ones were in the 80s. Also here, we raised the nutrients a little bit higher. You can see it's beautiful green. We went with EC from 1.5 to 1.6. And for the rest, we keep the same environment as all the other sativas. This plant only in the last week grew 13 centimeters. That's very short. That's even shorter than some of the indicas. It's a midget sativa, basically. Also with this plant, it's day 29. You can see how short it is and how fat and how big the branches are, how wide. I think even at the bottom, it's already 3 centimeters. And also here, what we did, as you can see, if I lift all the way up, we cut down a few branches. And the reasons we do this is that we want to have the airflow under, we want to have the growth out of the top, and we also want to make sure that no animals crawl into the plant.
Look at this internode distance, it's remarkably short, it's impressive. Less than 2.5 centimeters on the top of a sativa internode distance.
And this week we have a really, really special guest, my youngest daughter Lulu. And why we have her here, because when she was an 8 months old baby, my wife and I were traveling to Vietnam and Laos, hunting for the finest seeds in the world available. And I had a tip already a long, long time ago when I was living in Thailand that somewhere in Laos there is a really nice short sativa. Also already here, you can see the white hairs popping up.
Even the flowering time doesn't stretch too long on this one. It's a plant that it's harvestable in 10 weeks. With 11 weeks, you'll get an amazing quantity of crystal. And when you smoke it, you know it's pure sativa. You know that the high is cerebral, clear. It doesn't hit you on the legs, it hits you where it comes, up in the brain.
Yeah, and Miss Lulu now is 9 years old, eh? And she was a 10-month-old baby when we went through Laos and Vietnam, when we were hunting for the seeds. We were sleeping up really high in the mountains in little villages, and you remember it? Yeah, as a 10-month-old baby. Unbelievable.
Here in front of me we have the Arjan Haze number 3. It's 11 weeker, so it doesn't take too long to flower. It's a plant that stays compact in size but produces a lot of bud. It has the same bud formation, we can say, as the Super Silver Haze, but on a much more compact version. Right now the plant is given a feeding with an EC of 1.7 and a pH of 5.9. We raise the pH a little bit because sativas need this kicking the pH to absorb the, all the nutrients properly, especially when we talk about phosphorus and potassium. The EC level has been kept at 1.7 because we don't want to overload the plant with feeding. We want to let the metabolism of the flowering kick in first. I leave now the word to the master, the king himself, Arjan from the Greenhouse Seed Company, and to Steve Eger from High Times Magazine and the Cannabis Cup.
This plant has been growing for 3 weeks and flowering for 2 weeks now, so in day 49. But what you see here, look, the slim leaves of the sativa are really beautiful. But what do you also see? You see the smallest sativa ever grown. We finally accomplished to make a short sativa like an indica. And this is going to be a relief to all the big sativa growers in the world, because finally they can go indoor, make a really, really nice sativa plant. Look how the leaves are here. Look at this. Isn't this beautiful?
Yeah.
This is a pot leaf. Look
what's
at
the
this.
Bud structure on this plant when it's finished?
Big, but totally sativa. Yeah, I would say yeah, totally is not existing, but 80% sativa. Yeah, but there will be really, really nice colas on it. Yeah, and the biggest advantage of it doesn't grow high anymore. So all the problems with sativas are basically with this plant over. Right. This plant's going to win the High Times Cannabis Cup in 2009.
We're going to keep the tape, man. If you're wrong, you're going to be in big trouble because it looks bad. You know what I mean? So yeah. If you're going to say stuff like that,
I don't care, man.
You're going to have to back it up.
And we're very excited about this little jewel over here. What we have is the strength and power soaring sativa highs of the hazes, but it comes in a neat little indica package for some reason, which I'm very, very excited about. like to get this outdoors. I would anticipate from looking at the stage of growth and where it's at that these probably would end up finishing off somewhere in the 6 to 8 foot range, possibly with the longer season, maybe even 9 or 10. But I would assume probably that that's about as tall as they would get for a haze. That's very, very, very short plant. Because if you see the 14, 16, 18, 20 footers, those are all hazes and sativas that get the incredible heights like that. So for one to stay down at 8 to 9, 10 feet is truly a work of genius. And we're really looking forward to this.
I'm here with the editor of Buster Hype. Compared to the other sativas, already have big buds, eh?
This plant gets so bushy. It's as bushy as an indica. With the flavor, the high, and the compactness of the sativa.
Keep your daughters inside if they smoke this. Well, we've been following this plant for a few weeks, and everybody can see the sativa leaves inside here, but how small this plant has stayed, and how nice the scolas are forming in this plant. And the smell, eh? Here you smell also this lowest thing through. Eh?
This plant can challenge the production of indicas,
yeah.
I tell you. This plant is unbelievable. The structure of it, the internodes are so close, it's bushy, it's so sativa at the same time, it's scary. Creepy smell, creepy high. So peppery and fresh and minty. Unbelievable. I can't wait, dude. Really? Mm. I can't wait.
Great smoke. Look how many nice colas. All sativa colas here.
It's a dream come true. It's the fullest and heaviest sativa plant in the compact dimension. It's beautiful.
Look here. Look how nice this top cola is now.
It's full already. It's already closing up. It's incredible. Really fast.
Look, now we are nearly done already. It's already, look how nice crystals here. And look what a big bud for a sativa. It's ridiculous. And you see the really sativa leaves? So here's the proof for everybody. Yeah? It looks like an indica. Look how this plant is built up.
Bushy.
Look how many, all colas, everywhere colas. Around this plant, and can you imagine this plant outdoors going to be like massive, massive yield, yeah? So this is probably going to be the biggest sativa yielder that is available on planet Earth.
Also for this Aryan Sage number 3, in week 9 we steady on the pH at 5.8, and the EC is at 1.7, the plant can still take a lot of fooding, as you can see. The bud formation is on the way. It's always there with the structure, but the hairs are still all white, so it's a good 2 weeks to go. It's amazing the amount of colors that this plant has on, and amazing also how close the internodes are. You really have to show this to growers worldwide. It's a real achievement. An internode that is average 2 to 3 inches on a sativa plant.
We are in day 70, and this one is also ready to harvest. This plant we're gonna leave a little bit longer to have a little bit more crystal production. And you can see how the nuggets are growing. Look how beautiful the buildup of these, and hard, eh? They are hard, hard, hard. All hazes are already normally long and slim. So if you look at this plant, you think it's an indica until you see the leaves, that you see the really sativa leaves. Look in this, can you get this little leaf here? This is a sativa leaf. And look at this cola here, this is ridiculous. Look at this cola. So hard, you can just play with it like this. Look, bang.
Not only that, but other trademarks. For example, these double fingers here that shoot out at the end of the leaf, making it a 9 instead of a 7, that comes back throughout the plant. You can really find it everywhere in the plant. Also, this plant is now in the flushing stage. We're gonna get rid of the last little bit of feeding and fertilizers that are left in the medium and in the plant system. So to make sure that this beautiful, flowery, high sativa smell doesn't lose anything when it comes down to taste.
We're in week 11 with Aryan Sage number 3. Basically, we can harvest it also now. You can see already it's full of crystals, but still it's growing a little bit, so we want like to keep it because the buds are so big. But next week it's probably gonna come down. We are in week 12, harvest time for the famous Aryan Sage 3. I would really advise everybody to buy those seeds and grow them indoors so you get a little bit more of the Southeast Asian taste and of the haze taste. For the indoor growth, it's really fantastic because you see how small this plant gets and look how hard it is. You can really beat it up. It's a rock. This is a rock. And we're going to manicure it now. Very easy manicuring. Leaves just easily chip off. See, it's already, big leaves are gone already. What we do is we always get the big leaves first off so you see a little bit what you're doing. There's big leaves everywhere.
Snaps off really easy, yeah? Really, really easy to peel. really bushy for a sativa, incredible. And this really sweet, flowery smell that comes out, it's incredible.
So, this is the plant, the iron size number 3, the smallest sativa in the world, manicured. Look how many yield you have. Well, we've all been seeing the beautiful sativa leaves, and look what a nice colas you have here, all big colas. I don't know how many weight is going to be on this plant. It is huge. And this plant is only, I would say, 2.5 feet. It's as long as my arm, basically. You can see this is my arm, my shoulder. So it's only, 2-3 feet. And this huge cola on the top, and this is all the yield we got on it.
A full midget sativa.
The first in the world. Don't forget to buy your seeds from www.greenhouseseeds.nl.